Hello, my name is Ben Brownlee for BorisFX, and we're going to be taking our first introduction into optics. And we're going to start by taking a quick tour around the user interface. If your screen doesn't look like mine already, come up to Workspace, make sure you're on default, and reset all. And the first thing we're going to want to do is to open up a file. So I'm going to come to File, Open, and I'll use either Explorer or Finder to choose the image I want to start with. I'll take this one and hit Open. And with our image open, we can explore the interface a little bit more. Up at the top here, we have our toolbar. Now this toolbar is contextual, so it will change depending on where we are within the program. And coming down, we have our layers. So this is where we can see our original or any other filters that we have applied to our image. And speaking of filters, if we come all the way down to the bottom here, we have our list of filters, which we can see separated out into categories, and then the filters as icons at the bottom. And if I click on one of these, you'll now see that our layer has changed and it's renamed this to the filter that we're currently working on. Now moving downwards here, we have our presets. So every filter comes with a number of different presets. And just by selecting these, we can see the result updating in the big viewer in the middle. Certain filters also have on-screen widgets, which you can see in the viewer, and we can interact with these in real time to get the effect that we want. Casting our eye quickly to the top of the viewer, we now have our viewer controls. So this is where we can change things like looking at the different color channels, our viewer preview, our zoom controls, and all of the compare controls as well. And as you go through the essentials videos, we'll take a look at these as we need to. Over on the top right, we have our histogram, so we can get an idea of whether our colors are clipping. And just underneath that, we have our parameters. These will also change depending on which filter you're using. And if we move down to the bottom right-hand corner now, we can see any metadata connected to our image. So for example, if we've added in titles, artists, and copyright information, these are all going to be displayed within here. Likewise, if our image has camera data associated, we're also going to be able to see that here as well. And right at the very bottom, we have our status bar that's currently showing the image resolution and bit depth. So that's a quick overview of the UI itself. In the next part, we're going to start to manipulate our first image. So join me there.